Ann Meyer back with the Deco TV. Right now we're being joined by Deborah Russell, the Director of Workforce Issues for AARP. This is an issue that's getting talked about a lot at SHRM this year. So talk a little bit about some common perceptions and misconceptions about workers over 50.
Absolutely, and AARP has done a considerable amount of research really looking at the perceptions that employers have about older workers. So on the positive side, it's always they're loyal, they come to work on time, they'll finish a project, you know, see it through, that sort of thing. However, on the opposite side, it's they're not used to working with younger bosses or answering to younger bosses. They may not have the technological skills that are needed in order to really do the job, and that they may be expensive, particularly in terms of the cost of health insurance and that sort of thing. So it's a real challenge in terms of balancing, sort of understanding the value that older workers can bring to the workplace.
You talked about it a little bit, but talk about the differences between an older worker versus a younger one.
Yeah, I mean, here we are with a workforce of the future that's going to be very multi-generational. So we're going to see as many as four generations working side by side, 20 up to 70. And the needs are very different. You know, for boomers, we grew up with, you know, it was all about FaceTime, right? Making sure that the employer knew that you were there, that your boss knew that you were working, that sort of thing. For a younger workforce, you know, technology has really taken over and given them ability to work very differently. They can work from home. They can work remotely. If they're project-based, it's, you know, give me the project, go away, let me do it, and, you know, I'll hand it in. So I think those are some of the challenges in just, as a manager, how do I manage multi-generations who have very different needs and wants in the workplace?
In today's marketplace, what role does the mature worker play?
For a lot of employers, particularly in retail, they're looking at how do we better understand the older consumer as well? So having an older worker who can really relate to an older consumer has become a commodity. We're seeing that, for instance, in the financial services area. We're seeing it in healthcare and even some in retail.
For an employer, what are the benefits of hiring someone over 50?
They have the experience. They have the knowledge. And in all the research that we've done of our members, they want to work. They want to stay physically and mentally active. They feel like their experience is really can add value to the workplace.
With the explosion of technology, how can employers best engage a mature worker who may not be as techno-savvy?
Research has found that older workers are able to hold on to information and understand concepts once you teach them once. You can actually see that, for instance, some of the highest purchases of iPhones are older individuals. The largest growing group of consumers online are people over 50. So clearly technology is being incorporated in that age group as well.
How does the process, how does the process of recruiting mature workers differ from, you know, targeting a younger demographic?
Well, I think for a lot of older workers, and we're certainly learning this now in this economy with so many older workers unemployed, is that they have not been used to sort of today's job search process, right? So more jobs are online. You have to put your resume online. And so that's become sort of new and different for older individuals. So it may require some partnerships, for instance, with organizations that may do work with older workers, AARP being one, or the Administration on Aging, or there are a lot of different organizations that work with older individuals.
And technology is also obviously something that the younger generation is a little more used to, but it seems that the older workers can really teach the younger generation something as well in terms of what they've gotten over the benefit of years of having that work experience.
Absolutely. I think that you know, that partnership of mentoring younger individuals and that sort of thing is very much what employers are looking for, particularly thinking about older individuals who may become close to retirement or will think about retiring. The kind of knowledge and experience that they can transfer to younger workers is hugely beneficial.
How can mature workers best prepare for the job search?
Well, a couple of things. Number one, it's important to know that the job search process has changed, and technology has played a tremendous role in the job search process. Understanding what it means to post your resume online, it does not look like the resumes that you would put in the mail. Understand that employers are going through hundreds, if not thousands, of resumes. You're not going to get a thank you letter that says, "Thank you, Jane, for applying for this position. that's not going to happen. Better understanding what the labor market really looks like, the kinds of jobs that are available, things have changed. Manufacturing has gone down, construction has gone down. You may have to think about moving to a different location. Really, in this economy, it's learning how to think outside of the box when it comes to looking for jobs and really being as flexible as possible.
Is it ever too late to reinvent your career?
No, it's never too late. There are tons of stories out there about individuals who have moved into a different career, people who were in one industry that have moved into another industry. So it's never too late. Now, what it's going to take to get you there, are you willing to take the time and effort to do it? That's a different story. But certainly as we talk to employers, they are very open to the idea of older individuals coming into new industries and new opportunities.
Well, what are some suggestions for older workers to remain competitive in this marketplace?
It's really important to do your homework and understand the labor market, understand the kind of jobs that are available, understand the kinds of skills that they're looking for, the kinds of people that they're looking for. It's not just enough to put your resume out there. You really have to have a better understanding. And a lot of people bomb it during the interviewing phase because they haven't prepared for, you know, if you're going to go interview with this company, understand who the company is, what their mission is, what the products are that they're selling, and what role are you going to play in helping them be successful. That's what they're looking for.
Now, for those employers seeking to recruit mature workers, what are some critical factors that are key to attracting the 50-plus employee?
I think, first of all, for older workers, they say, you know, I'm looking for meaning. You know, I'm looking for meaning and purpose. So I think one of the ways to attract older workers is really talking about the value that they can bring. You know, what is it that, you know, that they can do to really help you as a company or an organization?
And what makes a company like Adecco truly live up to the promise of being an employer of choice for older workers?
Well, one of the things that I've been most impressed with Adecco is their Renaissance program. And it's a program that specifically promotes the value of older workers. They truly embrace the idea that older workers are a valuable resource for employers. And even those employers who say, I'm really looking for somebody younger for this position, they serve as great advocates for older workers because they have that relationship with the worker. They know what their capabilities are. So that program and just serving as an advocate on behalf of older workers in such an influential way because they do have that one-on-one relationship with employers probably makes Adecco sort of stand out above the rest.
Thank you so much for all the information. I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Of course, you can find out more by going to adeccousa.com.